الله أكبر الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله ملا قلوب أوليائه بنور حبه وشوق لقائه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له المتفرد بجلاله وجماله وكماله ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله والهادي إلى منهاج وصاله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فقد قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون قال سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وقال سبحانه وتعالى ولا تصاعر خدك للناس ولا تمشي في الأرض مرحا إن الله لا يحب كل مختال فخور وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يدخل الجنة قاطع أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليصل رحمه كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام All praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala All praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala The most merciful, the most kind The most noble and the most generous The most exalted and the most high All praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has created each and everything to the extent in which our eyes can see and our minds can comprehend. Know that it is the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All praises for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the highest, the most divine, the most exalted, and to Him is our eternal return. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ability and the tawfiq to act upon His commandments in the very view of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And salutations and praises upon our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his progeny, his companions, his pure wives, his children, and all the anbiya and all the prophets who have come before he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the blessed company of our beloved, our intercessor of the day of Qiyamah, the very man, the best of creation, the best of mankind. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be in His company in the highest levels of paradise. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Dear respected brothers and elders, honorable mothers and sisters, the very verse that I have recited you belongs to a very beautiful surah of the Quran. And I would like to highlight my khutbah around this very verse of the Quran. The ayah in the verse that I have recited before you belongs to the words of Luqman alayhi salam. In some opinions, as Luqman alayhi salam was accepted not as a prophet, this is the reason why those opinions mentioned Luqman radiallahu anhu. So no matter what opinion you take, whether it's alayhi salam radiallahu anhu, just know that Luqman alayhi salam, his specialty and also his remembrance is mentioned in the Quran from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's how special he was. The ayah that I've recited before you, Allah ta'ala says, وَلَا تُصَعِرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا Luqman alayhi salam is advising his son. Surah Luqman is actually a Makki surah. It revealed before the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is also to show that the people of Mecca, even pre-Islamic days, before Islam came, the people of Mecca had an idea of who Luqman alaihi salam was. They knew him to be a very noble individual, and he had a noble face in the community. He was already accepted as someone special and someone noble. The Prophet ﷺ received these very ayats from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before his migration. So that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he knows about Luqman alayhi salam and his story and who he was. One of the lessons to take from here is that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given these very verses so that he knows much better, in a better form, in a better way, how to consult and approach the people. Because Luqman alayhi salam was very well known for his character, and also he was very well known for his advices that he used to give to people. Here in the passage of the Quran in Surah Luqman, Allah Ta'ala in the very beginning to introduce Luqman alayhi salam, he says, وَلَقَدْ أَعْتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ. Allah Ta'ala mentions that one of the reasons why Luqman alayhi salam was so special is because Luqman al-Hikmah, he has given Luqman alayhi salam wisdom, hikmah. See, hikmah is such a special element. Not everybody has hikmah. You can be the smartest person, the most intelligent person. You can have and achieve the most highest positions or degrees. You can be the most intellectual person. But if you don't have hikmah to know what to do in a given circumstance, to know what to do in a given condition, in a situation, that's where hikmah and wisdom comes from. If you don't have hikmah, it'll be very hard for you to live life. Because you're not able to re-judge between what to do in a given situation. So Allah Ta'ala mentioning above everything, above wealth, above degree in education, being intellectual, those are all good things. But Allah Ta'ala says, what excels and exceeds more than this is hikmah, is wisdom. And Allah Ta'ala is saying that He has given this as a special element, a character within Luqman alayhi salam. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us wisdom as well. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. I don't want to take too long over here. As soon as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions and introduces Luqman alayhi salam from the beginning of this very verse, skipping all the way down, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions very quickly in how Luqman alayhi salam is giving his son advice. How many of us over here, as a father, as a parent, take that time out and sit down with our children, sit down with our daughters or our sons and give them advice? Giving advice is the first step. The other step is making them sit down to listen to me. That also becomes an issue. And when I am giving advice to my children, how are they perceiving me? How are they listening to me? Are they taking words offensively? Are they listening to you just for the sake of listening to you, and after that, they'll just go their way? Each and every one of us over here, we visualize the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam within our children. We vision this, we see this, we want this. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy. We want and envision in which each and every one of our children has the character of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We visualize this and we want this. But the lesson of the Quran, which mentions in Surah Luqman, where Luqman alayhi salam is having a conversation with his son, and Allah Ta'ala presents this as a dialogue in the Quran. This is a dialogue between Luqman alayhi salam and his son. And he starts off by mentioning to his son about worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he goes on to mention different aspects of life. He goes on to mention different advices in which he can use. And the very verse that I have recited before you is the fifth advice in which Luqman alayhi salam is giving his son. And he gave his son. And that is ayah number 18. Allah Ta'ala says through the words of Luqman alayhi salam that وَلَا تُسَاعِرُ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ. Luqman alayhi salam tells his son that وَلَا تُسَاعِرُ, Do not turn your face away from the people. So this ayah is talking about what? The betterment of people. It's talking about the qualities of people. It's talking about your character and my character towards people. What does this ayah mean? And what does this advice that Luqman alayhi salam is solely giving from his heart to his son to utilize for the rest of his life? And he says, do not turn your face away from the people. The different meanings here. First off, the word tusa'ir, in which is used in this verse, it comes from the word sa'ara. What does that mean? An easier understanding, a linguistic meaning. It's very interesting how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala breaks this down in the verses of the Quran. The word sa'ara, wala tusa'ir, to turn your face away, actually belongs amongst camels. This is an animal, a camel. When a camel has a neck disease, what happens to the camel is that the camel turns his face away. When they have a neck disease, the camel faces this way or the other way. It cannot maneuver and go straight. This is called sa'ir. An easier way to understand this is that amongst us, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us, when a human being has a stroke, they have a heart attack, when they have a stroke, if you see the patient or the person who has a stroke, their face is not straight. Their face is tilted away. Sometimes it's facing the right side, sometimes it's facing the left side, or something tilts and moves from the face. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from strokes. So that's the easier way to understand this. So Allah ta'ala is saying that don't make that face. Don't turn away from the people by making this face. And one of the meanings that we take out from here, as some of us, subhanAllah, we want to turn our faces away from a person we don't like. I don't like this person. I don't want to do anything with that person. Maybe this person did some wrong to you. You have every right to turn away from that person. You have every right. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying otherwise. Don't turn your face away from that person or people. You're in the marketplaces, you're shopping, and you see this person coming, and you say, oh man, I don't want to be here. I don't want to be here, I want to turn my face away from this person, I don't want to deal with this person, I'm going to go to the other side. Sometimes we come to the house of Allah. We come to the house of Allah, it can be Ramadan and non-Ramadan, it can be your regular salah. And the moment we place our eyes on that person, we say, you know what? I cannot believe that I have to see this person. And then what happens is what? You're praying the salah. You're destroying your whole entire ibadah. You're destroying your entire salah. You're destroying your entire mood. You're destroying your means and the reason why you even came to the masjid in the first place. You're destroying all of that. Now your ibadah is also gone, all because what? You don't like a certain person. For whatever reason, and maybe I'm not going into details. And this is the advice in which Luqman alayhi salam is giving his son, that you will have people in your life who will do you wrong. But still, وَلَا تُسَعِرْ خَطَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ. Do not turn your face away from the people. Do not. There's an English saying that goes by, forgive and forget. But what do? We like to forgive, we will forgive, but we will never forget. So much so that we probably tell our children also, remember that one uncle, he did this to me. You, after I pass away, make sure you remember it. That's the person that did that to me. We're ready to forgive, but we're not ready to forget. But when we look at Allah, we expect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me and also forget about hisab also. Don't ask me, Allah. Forgive me and also forget about what I did. We expect that from Allah, but we don't expect that from us. We don't. So, وَلَا تُسَعَدْ خَبْدَكَ لِلنَّاسِ. A second meaning from this verse, Luqman alayhi salam is telling his son that do not dismiss one person, one individual for an entire group. For example, you probably had someone to deal with. He's from the Bangladeshi community. Now this person did some bad transaction with you, bad mu'amilat, mu'asharat, bad dealings. So now what do? You judge one person for the entire community and say, you know what, all Bangladeshis are like this. Or all Pakistanis are like this, all Indians are like this, all Arabs are like this, all Africans are like this, all Americans are like this, and so on and so on. You deal with one person and you cancel out everybody else. That's it. You're judging one person and you're judging everybody else. That is also وَلَا تُصَاعِدْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ. You're turning your face away, not just from one person, but you're turning your face from an entire group of people. A very beautiful example is given in the Quran. When Musa alayhi salam, we hear these stories all the time. But sometimes we pass over the lesson. We read the stories, we hear the stories, but we pass over the lesson. Musa alayhi salam, he's walking outside of the palace of Fir'aun, and he sees two individuals fighting. One of the individuals was from his group, the Bani Israel, the lower class of Bani Israel. The other person that was fighting with his own people, he was from the opposite. He was from the group of Fir'aun. So when Musa saw the situation, naturally what are you going to do? You're going to side with your own people. You probably don't even want to hear what he has to say. In some narrations, it is also mentioned the opposite person that was fighting the people of Musa alayhi salam, he was actually an officer, a security of Fir'aun. So that made the situation even worse. Why? Because what is Musa alayhi salam thinking? Throughout his whole entire life, Fir'aun always came after his people. Always tortured his people. Always harmed his people. Murdered his people. So he's already thinking that this situation is very easy. He's coming here to attack my people. And the person who was also from amongst him, from his class and from his group, he's also calling onto Musa alayhi salam and saying, oh Musa, what are you doing? How are you? Take side with me. Let's handle this situation. This person is fighting with me. So what does Musa alayhi salam do? He goes out to handle the situation, and by mistake, as the Quran mentions, Musa al-Islam ends off what? Killing that person. But right away, Musa al-Islam acknowledges something. First of all, he finds out that the person he was helping, his own people, he was actually in the wrong. He was actually in the wrong. So he said, this is from Shaytan, min amali Shaytan. Quickly, he sought forgiveness from Allah, that Ya Allah, forgive me, I didn't know. And this was a mistake. So what does this lesson in the story show us? It shows that Musa alayhi salam had every right to think bad of that person, because all his life, the people of Fir'aun, what? They always came after his people, tortured his people, harmed his people, hurt his people. But what did he do? He judged one person. He said, this person is fighting with my people, and this guy is wrong. This person is wrong. This man is wrong. So I'm going to judge by an entire group, and I'm going to judge this person. But even after the story was found out, and this is the verses of the Quran, where Allah Ta'ala clarifies this very story, that your people was actually in the wrong. And the total and the complete opposite happens. When Musa alayhi salam's, when the Fir'aun's army was made to come after him, Musa alayhi salam had to run away. How did he find out that Fir'aun's army and the police are coming after him? How did he find out? One police officer from Fir'aun's army and police force, he came to Musa alayhi salam, not his people. One policeman from the police force of Fir'aun, he came to Musa alayhi salam and he said, oh Musa, I have bad news for you. You have the whole entire Fir'aun's police army and forces are coming after you. You leave this place. Now, if he didn't have any love for Musa alayhi salam, and he hated Musa alayhi salam, because why? Because he's from Bani Israel, then he wouldn't have said anything to Musa alayhi salam. But yet, he tells Musa alayhi salam. See how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches Musa alayhi salam from this, that from one situation to another, do not judge one person for an entire group. You never know. You never know. Each and every human being and individual has good qualities and character in them. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me and all of us a tawfiq to forgive the people. Not only forgive the people, but also forget about what they did to us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability and the tawfiq to not to turn away our faces from the people, even though we have every right to. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one, ultimately, He will reward us completely or even more. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Wa akhira da'wahum alhamdulillah. الحمد لله الحمد لله استعينه واستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد ان سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله ارسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعه من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعص الله ورسوله فانه لا يضر الا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أنصر المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم أنصر المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب اللهم ارحمنا فإنك خير الراحمين اللهم اشفعنا فإنك خير الشافعين اللهم ارزقنا فإنك خير الرازقين اللهم احفظنا فإنك خير الحافظين اللهم رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا اللهم رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة